All right, welcome to the most watched city council meeting in all of Monterey County. I'm still not sure what channel, 25, 26, it's in the 20s. And we are going to go ahead and take the field with 5/7 of a cast. I expect that there are numbers to fill out as we get into the evening. I do want to, just as a matter of information and so folks can plan their time, that the budget layoff notice item will be considered tonight at 7:30. So I think there was an email alert that went out. I'm not sure everyone had a chance to get it. We apologize for that, but just for planning purposes, if that's on anyone's to-do list as far as attending this council meeting, that will be at 7:30. We'll try and keep it lively until then, should you decide to wait. And with that, we have got a couple of City of Champions, but it looks like everybody's not here. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and jump directly to our presentation item, and I'll look to Mayor Pro Tem De La Rosa to introduce Mr. Bullock.
Yes, good afternoon, everyone. And it gives me a great honor to introduce our new Director of Public Health, Mr. Ray Bullock. But before I have Ray come up, I also want to introduce the president of the Steinbeck, of Hartnell College, Erica Padilla Chavez, and also our Deputy of Health, Dr. Hernandez. Thank you for being here, Mr. Bullock.
Well, thank you for this opportunity to come forward today and present. Is someone going to bump that up onto the projector and then I can advance? Or just because that first. Just briefly, I've been told that I need to limit my comments to 10 minutes, and Gloria knows that I could. Last time I spoke for 10 minutes, I was saying hello to my mother, so it could go on quite a while. So just send out the hook if I get too long. But we've taken a 45-minute presentation here and compressed it down, and I think we can get to the nuts and bolts. But one of the things that I want to accomplish here today is to pass along to all of the members of the Salinas City Council, as well as the constituents, that we are engaged in a strategic planning process for the health department. So often people don't understand or they have no clue what the health department is all about. So we want to impart that information, that we're engaged in it, and then also to share some data that will help people to understand how they can participate in that planning process. I'm a firm believer that if we don't set forth a plan to go somewhere, we're never going to get there. And so if our goal is to create a healthier environment, a higher quality of life for our constituents, we need to plan to do that. And so this process will hopefully incorporate the comments from a number of people to aid in that plan. So we'll just quickly go through. I think there's about 15 slides. Again, public health's role is changing. Over the past 50 to 100 years, we've moved from a paradigm which public health was primarily emphasizing on treatment of disease to engaging communities into healthcare promotion and to prevent disease from occurring. And so we need to plan for that change, and so that's a major part of what we're going to be discussing here today, is how do we plan for that changing role in public health. We're going to show a number of slides that show you what the data reveals for the City of Salinas and Monterey County as a whole, and then at the end we'll have some slides that show how the community can help participate in this process. As I've already indicated, that we've gone from curing disease to preventing disease. This slide on the right, it doesn't show up very well, but in the middle of that circle, basically you're looking at hereditary. Everybody's born with a gene pool, and that predisposes that individual to certain types of health outcomes. Then there's the individual lifestyles, is that first band that's next to the center, and then moving out to the socioeconomic determinants of health. Over 50% of our determinant of how well and how long we are going to live is based on our lifestyle choices. I'm going to put that in perspective. 10% of how well or how long we live is determined by our access to health care. So if you think back to 2 to 3 years ago when we were having the discussion about health insurance and coverage in the new federal health care reform policy, much of that discussion was tied to accessing health care. I am so glad that in that health care, even though it hasn't health care reform bill, there is provision for community transformation grants to address those measures such as socioeconomic determinants and lifestyle. So that's primarily what we're going to be dealing with at the health department. Back in 1988, there was the Institute of Medicines that developed a report on what are the 10 essential elements of public health. One out of the 10, so again 10%, deals with linking to or providing health care, medical care for individuals. 3 out of the 10 deal with policy determination. How do we do as a community develop policies that promote better health? I apologize, I didn't have an opportunity before I came to this meeting to look at the general plan for the city of Salinas to see if you have a health element. I applaud you if you do have a health element. If you don't have a health element, we stand prepared to help you draft one. I think that's something that cities, counties, states are looking at as they move forward in developing long-term strategic plans. How do we incorporate into that general plan those specific objectives that will help us address long-term health? And then mixed in amongst those 10 essential elements are some of the things that people traditionally think of as public health, such as follow-up of communicable disease, enforcing of regulations and laws. We have with us our environmental health director, the people that go out and inspect restaurants and those types of things. Those are the traditional markers, but again, I just wanted to add the emphasis that 3 out of 10 are dealing with policy, the very things that the city council can help us with as we move forward in this strategic plan. So we really will appreciate your participation in moving forward. This slide, it looks complex, but really, if you look at the bottom, the x-axis going across, you just think of that in the context of how many people are affected. If you look at the y-axis, the higher you go on the y-axis, that's the higher the cost. So again, it's another argument that we need to emphasize our work on things that can touch a lot of people at a low cost versus waiting until someone, and I always use the example of someone getting addicted to smoking. If we wait until they get addicted to smoking and then we deal with counseling and education, the recidivism, the reoccurrence, and all of the things that go with that, that's a very expensive interaction or intervention, the one-to-one smoking cessation class. On the other hand, if we just deal with some of the socioeconomic factors of the policies, if we minimize our access to smokable tobacco or smoking tobacco for our minors, that's a simple policy. It affects a lot of people, not very expensive to implement compared to a one-to-one smoking cessation class. Back in about 98, Dr. Satcher, who was the assistant director for CDC, came out with a paper that talked about the disparities in health outcomes that we have in the United States and in states and in counties. So his major push at that time was we can improve the outcomes for our population in whole if all we did was address those areas that are disparately affected to the low end of the spectrum. So we can, first thing we need to identify is, do we have disparities? And then if we do, focus our efforts on those areas that are suffering from poor outcomes. And so hopefully that some of our next slides will help you see those areas. County income disparities. If you look at the percentage of households, not the percentage of people, percentage of households just in the county of Monterey, 3% of the households in Pebble Beach are below the poverty level, 23% in King City. Again, it's an income disparity. If you look at education disparity, 2% of the population have less than a 12th grade education in Pebble Beach. 64% of that population in East Salinas do not have a 12th grade education. Does having a high school diploma make you healthier? No. Does having a high school education make you more employable? Yes. Does it give you a chance to make different choices, healthier choices? Yes. Does it generally go along with healthcare coverage? Yes. So even though education, a high school diploma by itself doesn't mean you are going to be a healthier individual, it again puts you in a situation where you can make different choices than for the folks that don't have that. Again, when you look at just the leading causes of mortality or age-adjusted death, Monterey County rates for the top three are actually lower than the state of California. So we're looking at disparities between Monterey and the state of California with this slide. So Monterey's actually doing better than the state when you look at indices such as cancer, heart disease, and stroke. I asked Krista, Dr. Hani is our epidemiologist, and she put together much of the slide presentation. The bottom five indices are areas that Monterey County is not doing as well as the state of California. We exceed as far as death rates for accidents, motor vehicle crashes. We exceed for chronic liver disease and cirrhosis. We exceed for suicide, and no surprise, I think, to this group, homicide. Those are all public health issues. Some people don't traditionally think of homicide and youth violence as a public health issue, but it truly is a public health issue because you'll see again some slides later how that disparately affects certain populations. A different indicator that I like to use when we start directing resources is premature loss of life. So, another way of putting that, if everybody lived to the age of 75 and then passed away, there would be zero. Okay, she's sending out the hook. I've got my 10 minutes. We'll get through this quickly. If everybody lived to the age 75 and passed away, we'd have zero premature loss of life. If someone dies at the age of 65, that represents 10 years of life lost. So what is it that's causing premature death in our communities? And so let's take a look at that real quickly. Again, in the county of Monterey, the primary cause of premature death is cancer, accidents, and in accidents, that includes vehicle accidents as well as personal accidents, heart disease, perinatal conditions. This was a surprise. When you look at perinatal conditions, you're talking about things like infant mortality and perinatal maternal mortality. We shouldn't be seeing that much life lost with perinatal conditions. Homicide and suicide. Both of those are, if you just look, there's your top six causes of premature death in our community. Then if you look at, let's break this down by ethnic categories. The primary cause of premature death amongst the white population is cancer, followed by accident, heart disease, and suicide. If you go to the Hispanic population, the top two reverse. Accidental death is number one, cancer. Homicide moves to number three, and perinatal conditions. That's the only place where those perinatal conditions shows up. So early access to pregnancy care is extremely critical for all of our population. Okay, Dennis is. So we need to get this data out. We want to also point out regional differences. The one takeaway from this slide is if you look at North County, accidents. If Highway 101, Highway 156, the Highway 1 north of Castroville, all of them are death traps according to the CHP. We can do public health policy to help address that. Education, I talked about why is education important. This slide depicts premature loss of life based on educational levels. So the person that has completed their high school education has a lower level of life lost. Comparisons within the county, I'll just, again, if you look and compare Monterey with Greenfield, we took that as comparison, there's 29% more life lost in Greenfield than there is in Monterey for the same population.